The residential property market could be on the comeback trail. The South African Reserve Bank's quarterly barometer bulletin shows that residential mortgage advances by the country's banks grew 4.9% year on year in August. It's the highest growth in home loans since 2010. It could be a sign that banks are getting back into the market after years of underperformance. Economist Mike Schussler joins us now to discuss this. Good morning to you, Mike Schussler. This looks like a good thing, doesn't it?
Yes, absolutely. I think if there's one or two things that we as consumers want a loan for, it's for a house where we would live and obviously save on rent, for example, or maybe for a car which takes us to work. And that, I think, is the most honorable, if you wish, of all the sort of loans that we can take from a consumer perspective, because nobody can afford, or very, very few people can afford to buy a home cash, for example. So the fact that the banks are back in that market, I think, is a very good sign for the housing market and the prices of houses, which obviously benefits the majority of South Africans, because the majority of South African households own their own home.
Why are the banks more enthusiastic?
I'm not quite sure why, but I think they were very scared. If we take a few steps back, the banks overdid it in the run-up to the national credit regulation. Then just after that, they also got hit by the Great Recession worldwide. And there were a lot of people that couldn't afford their homes as interest rates moved up, and other things like job losses started happening. So the banks felt that they were in a very dangerous position, because typically a home loan takes about 20 years or so to pay off. And especially in the first few years, there's a huge risk for them in that market. So I think they withdrew a lot from that market. The competition started heating up before then. And after that, we saw a lot of banks basically, except for their premium customers, really move out of the home loan market. And now I think there's a realization that that is a very important part of their book, and their book being the stuff that they lend out, and that they have a form of security. And also, I think overall, they feel that the assets are no longer overvalued, because home prices, house prices, haven't gone up much. In fact, they've declined in real terms after inflation for the last couple of years.
I was going to say, I mean, with prices as low as they are, I mean, why wouldn't you get in if you could?
Well, absolutely, because they know that even if the person can't pay, what will happen is they'll get most of their money back when they sell their home and property in possession. The other thing is the rules changes that have happened also made banks a bit weary, but I think they've learned how to live with those rules. And that's the message that I think banks have started understanding how to deal with stuff. And they probably now feel a lot more comfortable going there. And I think also from the consumer perspective, our salaries maybe haven't rocketed up, but over time, our salaries have gone up a bit more. So the affordability of houses has improved for consumers too.
And why would people get in, considering the exchange fees, the high interest rates that you have to pay on a monthly basis? I mean, what is the ultimate appeal there?
Well, I think for people, they want a place of their own for a family, and they can change it as they want. They don't have to pay rent. The friction in the home market, if you can call it that, when you sell a house and move into another house, that has reduced quite tremendously. For example, estate agents no longer charge 8%. You can go to buy a house and pay virtually 30,000 rand for the estate agents advertising and working on selling your house. Even if it is a 2 million rand house. So there's a lot of agents that have moved in on a much cheaper basis. So that's also improved things. Over time, transaction fees have come down from, or transfer fee tax rates have come down from the government side. So I think people, if they buy a house, there will be a period where the house prices again rise. and they will sit with equity, value in the houses. And if you look at the South African consumer, yes, we have a lot of financial assets, particularly in our pension funds, which is very, very good, one of the best in the world, in fact. And on the home front, we're in the top 40. But because house prices haven't risen, that hasn't been as much of a benefit or equity for families. When house prices again start to rise, I think that will be again in the forefront of making people feel wealthier. And home prices are very well, or home ownership in South Africa was at one stage at 62 or over 62%, around 64% or so. It's fallen back to about 57-58% of all households, but I think it's still the most spread asset in South Africa as such, and I think it is really something that we can be proud of.
Good. Well, let's be proud and celebrate. Mike Schüssler, thank you.